I want to welcome you from cloudy at beautiful Stockholm. A couple of words about myself. I have been a professor probably for too long. However, I took time here and there to be an entrepreneur. I started a number of companies, some of them more successful than the other. And my research work has been in parallel processing, fault-tolerant and dependable computing, wearable computing, and semantic and cognitive light. This talk today, let me be a little bit professorial. But first of all, I wanted to recognize my very talented co-workers and students. The credit for this work goes completely to them. And I mean, a number of companies which have been very generous with us, like IKEA, Philips, Gant, and a few others. So I will tell you a little bit about what is semantic light, and I will tell you from a very personal perspective. I will need to introduce the notion of structured light, and we get to the Internet of Light. But in fact, a subtitle for my talk will be Light as a Bridge Between Physical and Digital Spaces, and you'll see why. And then I will give you some real example of application of semantic light. I want to warn you that this talk is not about technology, although there is a lot of technology under the hood. I would like to use this talk to navigate at the surface and tell you about the intellectual substance and what could be achieved with very smart lighting. So generally, when we speak about smart lighting, we speak about technology, the transition to solid state lighting. We could have light which is more energy efficient, and so on. And we're gonna have very smart cities where the lights will be dim, and we have a lot of sensors in the light. But in the end, it's not about technology or energy efficiency. It's all about user experience. The user experience is always win, and I'll keep my talk at a level of user experience. I would like to try this system with you, and I will have a little poll. Have your user experience changed fundamentally with your mobile phone in the last 25 years? I obviously expect that most of you have been changing your life due to the mobile phone and mobile communication systems. We want to move into the lighting. And the question is, have your personal user experience, let's say in your home or the kitchen, the lights have been changed fundamentally in the last 25 years. If you look around you, probably around you there, at least in Stockholm, it's cloudy and it's getting, I'm using artificial light. The light is actually, which I use, is agnostic. Doesn't know anything what I'm doing right now. And it stayed this way for a very long time. What if the light in your kitchen will understand what you are doing? But let's move forward, and we'll come back to those questions. I hope that this gets you together with me to think about user experience. But it's not only about user experience, it's about you. And here I take a little bit of license to tell you a personal story and how do I got to be interested in light and why it's semantic light and what is smart light. In the late mid to late 90s, I was one of the people which got interested in wearable computing. And friends and family were asking me, what do I do? What kind of research do I do now? And I said, well, wearable computing. So what is wearable computing? A computer you wear? No. And let me explain to you or tell to you the story which I put together. So this is you, physical, on the earth, and there is a cloud of information, a digital representation of you, which Google is very happily using to bombard us with advertising. And has a lot of information about you. Now, the wearable computing will actually get a little bit more precise about you by building your double you, like your virtual you, and I will call it double you. And this double you, in a wearable computer world, have a number of dimensions. So for example, the dimension of biomechanical. So the mobile W, and we have a model of the way we are moving and the pressure we are putting on legs and feet and so on. So this model, when we move the leg, it's actually in a cloud, understand the move of the leg and computes the different stresses on your knee. When you move the hand, the model is computing similar things about your movement. And so on. So you eat something, the model should know to understand what will be the calories which you have ingested and what will be the effects of this food in terms of your health. If you think of push things a little further, you get to cognitive processes and the model will have a model of representation of the way we think. And this is not far-fetched, it's fairly close to what we are seeing now or what we see in the near future. So there are multiple models which I was interested in, some of them I built. But we get to the notion of a semantic W. What is a semantic W? It's we understand the notion of the context and the task with this human is doing and the relationship between the human and the objects around us. So if you look to this fellow, she is quite lonely. We are the objects. And then in the real world, in physical world, we interact with those objects. We could have representation of this in a cloud, and we should have those. But one of the questions which I had at the time is, how do we model the interaction between people and objects. Of course, we have a lot of research about communication between two or more people and so on, but we had at the time very little understanding about how we interact with objects. And in fact, I thought about this for a while, and I said, well, why don't we take example for what we do as human and what is connecting us with object is in fact light. We are seeing an object or our vision system, and the light is facilitating, it's bringing the information to us. So then I begin to think about the semantic W and the there was a point there where the light became the most important semantic object. And this was the time when I began to think about semantic light. And if you think about it, we are moving today from ink to light. We are writing with ink, with light, and we are reading with light. So let's add to the lights the concept of info light. And the semantic light is a light which has a number of characteristics. It understands the human. So we have some of the models which we developed for wearable. It's context aware and task aware. And this is a picture from our first patent, which is called Semantic Light. And the lamp here is able to look to this table and understand what is on the table. So if we put a picture on the table or a piece of paper with the text, the lamp is able to read this and do a search, for example, and bring information which is related to this, and this information will be projected on the table. And if we move the piece of paper, the light will be moving with the paper, and the light is tuned to a specific person's vision. So let me give you some examples of user experience, because that's what we want to do. And let me give you an example of, let's say, a map folding. This is a map of Stockholm. In the middle, there is southern islands. So Stockholm is a bunch of islands, but let's not speak about this. Let's speak about myself. I'm a terrible map folder. Once I open the map, I cannot put it back. But semantic light could help. So on the same table, which you have seen in a previous slide, I put this map. The system understands that it's me. I have a model that Zary is a complete failure of folding maps, and is inviting me to fold the map correctly. And it's a dynamic process. So once I fold it, the system recognizes this and tell me how to fold it the second time and third time and fourth time and so on. Imagine that you have an IKEA system to put together, and if you are like me, I put it together all the way to near the end to find out that actually I have to take it apart and redo it. So this could be useful. But let's take a little bit more a more complex example. And by the way, the lamp is built, exists, and those are real behavior, real task which the lamp is doing. Let's do a T with this lamp, with the semantic light lamp. And the reason we do a T is some work done with some colleagues of mine in England, where the physician could prescribe technology. And the test for an elderly person to remain independent is to be able to make a T. So if we could help the people to make a T, perhaps they will be living longer in their house and independent. So this is the table which you have seen before. There is there's a number of glasses and a tea maker. The semantic light understands and looks to this and creates the responses that is create light, which soon we call structure light, which is kind of enveloping each of the items. And once we put box of tea, the task is understood by the system and is saying, okay, 97 degrees Celsius, 2 to 3 minutes, 2 bags, you have a good tea. And we proceed on putting some water and heating the water and so on. Immediately when we put the water, there is the system is computing the temperature and it's starting to wait for the water to get from 100 degrees to 97 degrees Celsius. Once it's getting there, the system is communicated through light and infrared. You see that the pot got green. And it's we are putting the tea inside, the tea is brewing, and it's helping us getting exactly the right timing. The tea is ready, and once we put it into the glass, immediately we are asked, you know, so what's, how do you like your tea? And I could touch a particular temperature, and the system will understand this and will wait till the tea is ready. And this is a tea with a semantic light. I spoke about structure lighting, and this is something which we have to get out of the way before we are going forward. If you look to artificial light, you have most of the time two types of light. One is ambient light and the other is spot lighting. By structure lighting, we mean taking an object. Let's say you take your mobile phone and you move it in the 3 dimension, and the light understands the move of the phone and structure the light dynamically around the phone. So only the phone is illuminated and the shape of the phone is understood. So there is no light which is coming out of this. So here in the picture we have some glasses from IKEA and they are illuminated with structure lighting. And you see a few more examples. This is in the upper left corner, you have a set of the setting for breakfast, and the glasses are illuminated, and the system understands the shape of the glasses, the shape of the plates. Of course, if you move them, the structure light is moving with that. On the lower right side, we have exactly the same thing, but the lighting has changed for evening, and it's a different setting. In fact, our demonstration on this system was that if you put a morning paper on the table on the top, the system is setting for the morning breakfast. And if you bring a bottle of wine, but put it on the table, it's thinking that you want to have dinner and it's setting the dinner table. So now let me show you a video which has been promised. And this is showing you structure lightings and some of the beginning of understanding lighting and forming the light accordingly. The point of the video is forming light and structured lighting, and regular objects in your house could become beautiful pieces of art, and this light could be used though in many other areas. One of the areas of my personal interest is in creating light without shadows, and this has application in the medical field, in dentistry, and so on. But let me move forward. Well, If we are able to illuminate objects and add meaning to the objects, then perhaps we have another form of Internet of Everything, which we call the Internet of Light. And this has a number of advantages. In the Internet of Things of Everything, we add sensor tags to the everyday objects. In the Internet of Lights, anything and everything which is illuminated by semantic light gets to be intelligent. Think about the glasses of the grandma which you have inherited. We're not going to add to this tags and sensor, but they could become intelligence under the semantic light lamp. And now we are going to another video. And let me see here. Okay, I need to tell you a little bit about this video. This is a metaphor for explaining and showing the Internet of Lights. The metaphor is inspired by IKEA, where we could take a piece of wood, in this case a train, and make it a very smart toy. We show to the lamp a story, and the lamp is creating an environment around the train. The train is context aware and task aware. You could imagine the train going around the world and visiting different countries. In this case, the book has four different areas, a farm, a forest, a lake, and so on. And in each area, the carriages have different characters. And if you touch the characters, they are going to be free. So let's see the Internet of Light in action.
All aboard!
Showing you a few applications, but first let me mention to you some an important component of this. In the previous video, you have seen the lamp, which is looking like any IKEA lamp. Of course, the lamp had sensors, camera, projectors, and a computer. The challenge was to disassemble this lamp and use all the sensors or most of the sensors in your smartphone and to control the light with your smartphone but in a bidirectional way. So if I point to an item in a 2D or 3D space, the light will form around this object, but I also get in my phone information about this object. And let me go forward here. So I'm gonna show you another video. So we have achieved the goal which I was dreaming in the late 90s of connecting the physical and digital space and reconnect with light. We solve a few problems on the way. So the user is able to experience a very simple pointing with an unmodified phone to an object, and the word is becoming clickable. You could collect things around you, information, and so on. And as a result, I decided that we need to start a company which will bring this to you. So Seritera is based on Semantic Light. In the back, this is the first Semantic shelf, which is in London now, on Regent Street, soon to be accessible with any phone. The system is up free, it's HTML5. The shelf knows exactly what is in the shelf, and it's reacting exactly as you have seen before. And let me show you another video. I want to finish this fairly short adventure at the surface of Semantic Light with Semantic Light in a living laboratory. We deploy this into an apartment in Stockholm, and we wanted to understand what people could do with this. And they have amazed us with their creativity. So here is a party in a Stockholm apartment. The people are not actors. They are the people who are living there and their neighbors. Yeah. great. So I think that I'm going a little bit over my allotted time, and I apologize to all of you. I hope that I trigger your interest in exploring more about how to make life extremely smart and how could light help us to have a better life.